สวัสดีครับ Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great honor and pleasure to present about the progress of Thai MOOC. This year is the 10th year of IEC, International E-Learning Conference, and it's the 20 years of Thailand Cyber University Project. And can you guess how many years of Thai MOOC? Anyone know how many years of Thai MOOC? Yeah. Yes. This is the third year, and now we enter the fourth year of Thai MOOC. Okay. So every year at the IEC International Conference, we have a session to update about the focus of the Thai MOOC. So now this is the session to update. In this morning, I'm very pleased that our permanent secretary of the Ministry of Higher Education, Science and Innovation. He present about the progress of the MOOC in overview, and I will follow his structure and but go into more detail. I have many equipment. So my presentation outline is very simple. The history of Thai MOOC, the current statistic, and also the future direction. Before I start presenting about the Thai MOOC, can I have your kindly attention to let me know about how you're familiar with Thai MOOC? Can I ask you the questionnaire? How many of you have going to visit Thai MOOC website before the conference? Can you raise your hand? Wow, thank you very much. And the second question, how many of you have learned at least one course from Thai MOOC? Wow, more than 800 people. And the last question, how many of you got a certificate from Thai MOOC course, at least one certificate? Please raise your hand. Oh, more than 200. Wow. The success rate is more than 20. Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much. So we have experience about learning MOOC course and in the Thai MOOC also. Let me talk back about the history of Thai MOOC. We start from Thailand Cyber University Project in 2005. Then the project do many initiatives to support the university to minimize the investment cost on the content and also on the system. 2005, Thailand Cyber University Project invest on the open courseware portal to let the university to develop the open courseware and sharing among universities. And then 2010, we have a e-learning professional certificate course. This may be the similar way of MOOC providing be open for all. We did not have limited number of attendants or participants. So we have more than 600 teacher and professional attend the course. In 2014, we start TCU Globe Project. This Globe Project, we try to interconnect among the open courseware portal to make it more friendly and more easily for the user to search to the open courseware or open educational resources throughout Thailand and also to the international portal also. And then 2017, we starting the Thai MOOC project. Within the digital economy policy of the government, the Office of Higher Education started Thai MOOC project. with the support from the ministry at our permanent secretary already mentioned. And now, two of the three ministries are merged together to become a Ministry of Higher Education, Science and Innovation. That make us work more closely, and we will work together to make the Thai MOOC more reliable and confident platform. Let me share about this picture again. This is our goal and our vision that can MOOC as one of the mechanism to enable the lifelong learning of Thai people. So we have this vision that every people in every age and every state of education, they can utilize the MOOC as a way of development themselves into the education level or to upskill or reskill for their purpose. Three components, three important components that we have to implement are the MOOC courses. We should have as many MOOC courses as we should, and in different level of education to support the lifelong way of learning. We should have the learning portfolio to report the progress, the learning record of the learner, and also the credit bank system to record, to keep the success of the learning of the learner. So they can utilize the credit bank to transfer the academic achievement or successful credit to their university or to their educational institute. So these three components are very important mechanism. To enable the learning of the student and university student to learn for academic credit, or the worker to learn to upskill and reskill, and also for the owner to learn for recreation. So we try to achieve this picture, this component. And let's see how far we can go now. This is the system that we try to implement. In the left hand side, maybe I push wrong. Okay. This is a mechanism of the conceptual model for learning. People can learn and get the certificate without any examination, but they did not have any credit earned. But people can learn and go to the test bank and do a testing, and if they pass, they can get the credit record in the credit bank. And after they record many credits, they can transfer to their home university and also transfer to the certificate. The system like this, we try to make it happen or implement it. But now we're still in the middle phase, still not implement totally yet. From the 4 year of Thai MOOC journey, Thai MOOC roadmap, we starting from 2017, we create the foundation. Foundation means the platform, means the pilot MOOC courses. We are very happy that many universities through the 9 regional network of the university, many universities support us and create the MOOC course as a pilot project. And also we do the standard and practice of MOOC course development. And also we create the platform to provide the MOOC course. Okay. In the second year, this is the statistic of our progress now from MOOC 300 plus course and 80 member university comparing to 150 university. We have maybe 50% of university join us to produce the MOOC course and provide it as a education to all. We have totally 150 learners registration, but maybe some of them are registered more than one account, maybe approximately allow 120 registration. And this is the MOOC category. You can see that we have many MOOC category for learning, from supporting the life skill, the management, and also some in the art and culture and language and religion. Also the health and medicine also. This is the distribution of the age of our learner. We are so happy that many people from different age, they learn and utilize and got benefit from the MOOC way of education. This is the demographic of the learner. The yellow dot show the place, the place that they open the Thai MOOC website. And this is our standard and practice that researched by Dr. Pravinaya and Dr. Samarkan. We use this as a guideline to ensure that all the MOOC course that open in the Thai MOOC platform at least meet the minimum level of quality and have a guideline checklist for the MOOC course development. For the second year, 2018, is the year of inclusion. Inclusion means that we try to include more and more university, and also to include other institute, not only university, but also the public organization, including we try to have an international collaboration with the JMOOC, Japan MOOC, and also K-MOOC, Korean MOOC. And also now we have a work collaboration with Taiwan MOOC and maybe more and more countries that we can work together to provide the education to Thai people and also to all. The inclusion, we work with 9 regional university network and to recruit university throughout Thailand. And now, so far we not only have university work cooperation with Thai MOOC, but also we have many public organizations. You can see from the logo that very big public organization. For example, the Office of Civil Service Commission, maybe similar to Taiwan MOOC, that training government officer is one of our agenda, because we have more than 300,000 government officer. So we work closely with Office of Civil Service Commission, try to implement, try to produce maybe more than 20 MOOC courses to train the government officer. We starting from training the young government officer, the one who just enter the government side sector. And then we try to create more MOOC courses to support more senior government officer. And also we work with other sector of education level. For example, the second logo, you can see The second logo you can see, this is the Distance Education Institute. It's a kind of a non-formal education in Thai system. So we work closely with Distance Education Institute. They are utilizing MOOC course that already produced to be one of their elective courses in their curriculum. And also, we work with the Institute of Community College, distributed throughout Thailand. They have a diploma level education. They also try to utilize MOOC course in the Thai MOOC, and also they will produce some MOOC course that benefit to their education. And also, this is another big company, big organization, Thailand Professional Qualification Institute, TPQI. This is the certified, the skill-based certified institute. This is a public organization under the Prime Minister. So this organization make sure and certify, distribute the certificate to the one who can work and certify that this person have ability, have competency to work in different area. So before they can certify the one who apply to certify, they have to learn knowledge, and then they have to practice. So for TPQI, we work closely. So the one who want to certify, they can learn from the courses in Thai MOOC, and then they go to practice, and then go to certify by TPQI. So this is another pathway that MOOC course can enable skill-based training. And also you can see many public organizations, the Department of Economy, Digital Economy Promotion Agency, also the Ministry of Public Health, also do now in the period of initiative to produce many MOOC course in the public health, and also to promote the rational use of medicine to people, and also to the health professional also. And you can see the logo of the elected government agency. And you can see logo of the Sukhothai Thammathira, the top, the big open university in Thailand. We also work closely to utilize MOOC course, and Sukhothai Thammathira try to compare and check the content, and they allow those who complete the MOOC course to transfer the credit to become credit in Sukhothai Thammathira University. But now we are work closely to check the MOOC course content that is equivalent to the course in Sukhothai Thammathira curriculum or not. And many universities that we work together. In the bottom, you can see we work with many organizations, international organizations. So you can recognize that now there are many educational institutes in different level of education. We join together in the Thai MOOC platform. So maybe this is the good side of have MOOC course in different level of education. So we can create that picture that we want every people from different level of education utilize MOOC course and earn the credit, and they can progress to another level of education. This is the sample of the MOOC course. This is our MOOC course that we work together with JMOOC and KMOOC. Very interesting, the specialized interested tourism series of course produced by Thai University, Pae Pha Luang University, and also Dusit Thani College with the Jeju National Open University. So if you're interested to listen more, tomorrow in the afternoon they have one room to present the progress of the collaborative project and also the data science course. And this is a Taiwan MOOC that Professor Liu kindly shared about our collaboration. Taiwan MOOC opened three courses in Thai MOOC platform and very success. Many Thai people learning from Taiwan MOOC course. And Taiwan MOOC team also would like to share the experience and more about the development tomorrow afternoon. If you interested, you can attend in the room. So in this year, we try to harmonization, mean that everything that we have, we try to align and we try to adjust, and we can see the gap, and we try to improve our way of MOOC development. We try to create the ecosystem for the people to learn in the MOOC course also. This is the pathway, learning pathway from the non-formal education in the basic education level. They can go to the diploma level and they can transfer their credit and learn from the university. Maybe this is very initial phase, very first early phase, but we can see some of the success evidence, but we will go along this pathway. Can I go back one slide? Okay. Now, recently, the initiative about MOOC way of education now have an impact on national policy. There are many policy on education, especially on digital education that mention about MOOC way of education to support the development of the people and also the education part, many government policy. You can see the biggest policy is 20-year national strategic plan mentioned about learning from open education from MOOC. And also many policy digital education development plan, 5-year digital plan for economic and social development, and the second 15 years long range plan of higher education. Okay, and in next year, we plan to have some way of transformation. We have to rethinking about how way of provide a way of Thai MOOC. We starting from as a MOOC course provider, educational provider in 2015. We include more educational institute, university, and also public organization. Now we have more MOOC course, and then we have to rethinking how we can do a strategic way to support the lifelong learner in Thailand. We will change from educational provider, educational MOOC provider, to become a national MOOC platform provider. We think now more and more university and more educational institute and also public organization, they are interesting and see the benefit of MOOC way of providing education. So they will produce the MOOC course and they have their target customer. So they need the platform. So to minimize the investment on the platform, So Thai MOOC should become the MOOC platform provider for all university or organization for free. And we should create the ecosystem for lifelong learning to support the lifelong learning way. We should create a reliable and secure technology infrastructure and for all university and organization to utilize. We should have a system of quality assurance to make sure the quality of the MOOC course. We should produce more tools to support the teaching and learning in the platform. And also we should record the learner profile, learner portfolio, and we should encourage the learning community. And also analytic tools to learn from the behavior of the learner, credit bank, and also the mechanism to encourage the continuing professional development of all people. So National MOOC platform provider maybe can benefit in this criteria, minimize investment and maybe one-stop marketplace for learning, and also have a reliable, secure, and accessible infrastructure, consolidate learner profile, learner records, learner portfolio, and also learning credit. We have we can implement the learning community or teacher community to connect learner and also connect teacher and to let them share among themselves. And also we can when we have a lot of MOOC course inside the platform, we can then they can work together to create a series of MOOC course to become a professional certificate. And also we can invest on the credible assessment system, for example the e-testing system and also the test bank. Maybe it's nearly the lunch time, the battery is out. Okay. Try to support the government policy that our permanent secretary have already mentioned. The policy about the creating foundation for the future is one of the biggest policy that the Ministry of Higher Education, Science and Innovation will go toward that way. So National MOOC platform will be one of the foundation to support the higher education and maybe and including our education level, and also providing cooperation with other content provider to establish a national digital learning platform. This is another policy, not only MOOC but also national learning digital learning platform, including other kind of content. For example, the open courseware or open educational resources, not only MOOC courses. I will show some detail the slide later. And also decrease the educational gap and increase opportunity. So MOOC course will cooperation with university, industry, and the TPQI, Thailand Professional Qualification Institute, and we work together to enable the skill-based MOOC for upskill and reskill in many careers. And also we cooperate with university and also related organization, the standard organization, to enable the credit transfer from one university to other university. Now there are many university try to utilize the MOOC course to let the learner earn the credit before enter the university. But transfer from one university to another university is another level of success. For National Digital Learning Platform, this is the our one of our goal that we can cooperate with other content provider from different level of education. Some they have e-learning course in the basic level of education. Some they have open courseware or open educational resources. The Ministry of Science and Technology from the past, they have a big portal of open educational resources in science and technology. So if we can cooperation and work together, we can create a unified system that benefit to a learner, to user, that they can search through and they can utilize any kind of content, including the MOOC courses. And if they learn the courses, they can record their learning portfolio and learning profile, and also their successful of learning. Another system is to create the MOOC directory. This is now in the process of development. Nowadays, not only Thai MOOC, but many major universities in Thailand, for example, Chulalongkorn University, they have a very famous MOOC portal, Chula MOOC, very famous, and many people can learn and benefit from the portal. And also, there are many universities from now, the Thammasat University and also Mahidol University, a very big university in Thailand. So from now on, there may be more universities to open the MOOC provider platform. So how can we enable the unified system and let the user benefit and can searchable all the MOOC course? So we starting to create a system we call the Thailand MOOC Directory System, and we can work with the university that join us, partner with us to try to collect the metadata of the MOOC course into one directory. So it benefits the user, they can search through all MOOC course from any provider. And also we looking forward to work with international MOOC provider that we can collect the metadata and enable the searchable for the people, for the learner. So this is the progress of the Thai MOOC, and all I can speak as a representative from the Thai MOOC project and all member university that we work together, that we believe that together we can raise the quality, flexibility, and affordable of higher education together. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Khap Ajarn Anuchai, Thai MOOC Daddy. We have heard about secret of Thai MOOC. In comparison to Taiwan MOOC, we can say that both are very credible national level MOOC. And for Thai MOOC, Professor Anuchai explained it clearly that it belongs to everyone here. We can always learn anything that we want on Thai MOOC system. We can have some hope that in the near future, we're going to have national credit bank system. We can see that it will serve not only for our own pleasure of learning, but it will link up with our future. For example, it link up with TPQI. So if you want to progress in your professional life, then you can learn something from Thai MOOC to gain enough knowledge and then continue to have real tests with TPQI organizations. So that is something really pleasing. And saying so, we also have question on the discussion board. Khap Ajarn Anuchai. One person asks, who owns the right of the content? Who is the after developing a MOOC course, who own the content? Yeah. Who own the copyright, please?
There are many ways to provide the MOOC course in the Thai MOOC platform. The first way is to get the funding from the Thailand Cyber University project. If the MOOC provider the university or the faculty member, you apply the funding from the Thailand Cyber University project. The content, the owner of the content is a copyright share among the Office of Higher Education and also the teacher or the faculty member, the owner share between both. So we would like to make sure that we can provide the MOOC course in our platform. So the Office of Higher Education want to take share ownership with the content owner, but the content owner can use the MOOC course to the benefit of academic promotion. No problem. They can use the MOOC course to apply for the assistant professor or associate professor or any academic promotion as they want without any problem. So this is the first pathway. But the second, if the university produce the MOOC course by their own budget and they want to open the course in the Thai MOOC, we have some regulation that the MOOC course should be open for free to all people that want to learn, but they can utilize the platform and also they are the owner of the content. But they should allow everyone to use. They have to declare the Creative Commons as CC BY and reusable. Okay, this is two pathway to open the course.
Okay, cup.
Okay, we still have 6 more minutes until lunch time. So, any question from the floor, please?
Okay, there is one question. Please proceed to the microphone, please. And please start with introducing yourself. Thank you.
My name is Hinpata Thasaku from Panyapiwat Institute of Management. I have some question as you have a lot of experience in this area. As the MOOC is quite a new form of learning, so could you please share what are the challenges when you launch the Thai MOOC program?
Challenges from the teacher, right? The teaching and learning, right?
Overall project, for example, for the teacher, and how to encourage the learner to attend the course or enroll the course or the infrastructure, something like that.
Or issue are challenging. we starting on 2017. That's very new. The concept of MOOC and MOOC way of education are very new to Thai people and also to the Office of Higher Education, Thailand Cyber University Project. We have to recruit a lot of professors from university to try to make understanding and try to develop the project. So the challenging is the system, the platform are very complicated. So we need a lot of engineering expert to learn. We need not create the platform by ourselves. We adopt the open edX. That is very, very good system, but also complicated system. We adopt the open edX and we face many difficult to implement the system at the first. So, Up until now, we are very familiar with the system now, and we can make sure that we can make the system more stable. This is the platform, but we are looking forward to partner with the EdTech organization that we invite a representative from EdTech, and we discuss together how we can work and how we can get the inside technology knowledge. And we can make our system more stable, more reliable. This is the technology part. So this is the way that we think investment on the platform is a huge effort and budget. So that way, we think that we should do a national MOOC provider platform and decrease the investment from many university and organization. From the teaching and learning, our faculty member, we are familiar with the teaching in the classroom and also experience about e-learning course. But when change to the MOOC courses, there are different story, because MOOC courses utilize the video as a way of deliver content. So the teacher have to present anything via the video. They have to have the way to design the content, not only deliver the content similar to the classroom, but they have to design. They have to have concise, precise message to present via the video to shorten the deliver time. And also, they have to think about how to create the content that more interesting. Not only teacher talking head, but also some infographic, some outdoor shooting, something. So the way of design, the content delivery is not familiar to Thai faculty. So we have to learn. We have to learn from each other. And this is a good thing that happened within the Thai MOOC project, that from the teacher that very reluctant to appear in front of the video, they can learn from other teacher, they can learn the technique. With the working together network, they can learn and share each other. Now, many faculty members that produce the MOOC course are very happy, and they feel that they can come back to the classroom and they can teach better because they have the way of thinking of deliver content. They design the content, they design the message, they design their presentation more and more better than before. So many aspects are challenging, but from the starting until now, third year, we can see that from the first year, the faculty member that joined our project say that this is the only one time I will not participate in the MOOC course anymore. But when the second year, they also submit the application. The third year, they submit the application. This is some evidence that the teacher feel happy to do a MOOC way of education, and we develop better and better so far. From the learner side, we have no doubt that at the first year that we open, many learners attend us, and from different age of them, from the student in university, student in school, until the working people, and also the senior people, they also attend and enjoy the MOOC course. So from the first year until now, we think we are ready to move forward, but we have to think about strategic move, and without the support from all of you, from the faculty member, and from the university, and from many organizations, we cannot go this far. But we also hope that we can join hand in hand to move forward to another level and to support the lifelong learning of the people in the country.
Okay. Wow. There is one question from Professor Marina, please.
Уважаемый профессор Анучаев, вы такой увлеченный, так полезно рассказываете о том, что вы делаете. Я хочу спросить.
Аджан, как хобкун самрап, комун ти пен прайо, наха, гамланг за тхам, кам тхам топай.
Скажите, пожалуйста, а используете ли вы MOOC-и для повышения квалификации? И пользуются ли они спросом. С удовольствием ли используют учителя, преподаватели вузов? Квалификация, когда закончил учиться и опять учишься, обновляешь знания. Только в университете используют MOOCs или когда закончат, тоже используют?
มีการใช้ MOOCs ในมหาวิทยาลัยแล้วหลังจากจบมหาวิทยาลัยอะค่ะมีการสามารถใช้ต่อได้ไหมคะ
นี่ครับผมสอบภาษาไทยแล้วน้องแปลผมสบายใจที่สุดเลยครับครับคือจริงๆแล้วเนี่ยตลอด3ปีที่ผ่านมาเนี่ยครับเราเห็นมหาลัยอาจารย์เนี่ยจำนวนมากนะครับที่พยายามประยุกต์ใช้ MOOC ในการเรียนการสอนนะครับบางมหาลัยนะครับใช้ MOOC เตรียมนักศึกษาก่อนเรียนนะครับบางมหาลัยเบรนเดดเข้าไปในการเรียนการสอนนะครับบางมหาลัยใช้เตรียมนักศึกษาก่อนออกไปฝึกงานนะครับและมีหลายมหาลัยที่ประสบความสำเร็จในการเตรียมนักศึกษาให้สอบใบประกอบเขาเรียกว่าcertificate เนาะ certificate ของการใช้ IT ของค่ายต่างๆนะครับเรามี MOOC course ที่รองรับการฝึกอบรมแบบนี้ด้วยนะครับ
Let me translate into English. Meanwhile, she asked if Thai MOOC serve only during higher education period or not. And Dr. Anuchai said, no, it is for lifelong learning and it serves for many purposes, not only for formal education, but it is also for personal learning, something like that. So without, I think we are running out of time, still more questions on the board, which we will come back later. But right now, please join me to give Thai MOOC Daddy a big hand.
Let me take this opportunity to announce a couple of things for the lunch and the afternoon session. In the afternoon, there will be 6 sessions in parallel, including the talk from invited speakers and the workshops. I would encourage all the participants to take active parts in those interesting sessions. Some will be conveyed in English, and some will be in Thai. And the afternoon session will start from 1:15.
Okay, let me preview you. The first room, room 211, we're going to have invited speaker, and I am very excited. We're going to have professor from Japan, Professor Yoshida Masami. He will share about here analytics issue of MOOCs. And we're going to have Professor Sang Hun Cheng, Secretary General of ASEAN Cyber University Project. He's going to talk about the birth of ACU and MOOC-related activities. And then we're going to have... speaker talking about digital learning open LMS, that is room 211 in English. Then we're going to have room 212 also in English. We're going to have Professor Soraini, Vice President of Wawasan Open University of Malaysia. She's going to kindly share with us information about enhanced learning experience using digital flip books. And then we're going to have room 213 in Thai language. ห้อง213เป็นภาษาไทยนะครับจะเป็นการพรีเซนต์เป็นงานวิจัยจากจุฬาด้วยนะครับเป็น iChat Smart Classroom นะครับสำหรับไทยมูกซึ่งอาจารย์จินตวีก็จะเป็นหนึ่งในวิทยากรนะครับหลังจากนั้นก็จะเป็น YouTube จะมาเล่าให้ฟังว่าจะใช้ YouTube เพื่อการเรียนการสอนให้มีประสิทธิภาพมากกว่าปกติต้องทำอย่างไรในห้อง213หลังจากเบรกก็ยังมีถ้าใครอยากรู้ว่าซีเครตของไทยมูกที่กำลังจะเกิดขึ้นต้นปีหน้ามันจะมีฟีเจอร์เด็ดๆใหม่ๆอะไรต้องไปอาจารย์ดร.ชุติพรของ AIT จะมาเล่าให้ฟังนะครับและมันมีของดีเยอะๆมากเลยขอบอกไว้เลยนะครับเช่นเกมมิฟิเคชันเช่นเกรดบุ๊ครุ่นใหม่นะครับห้องต่อไปครับห้อง214ถ้าท่านใดเป็นทีมพัฒนามูกสนใจเรื่องการถ่ายทำวิดีโอคลิปให้มันว้าวนะครับปกติเราจะมีวิชาวิดีโอ X ให้เรียนนะครับไปเรียนรู้ได้จากทีมของบางมดเลยนะครับที่ห้อง214ครับภาษาไทยต่อไปห้อง215 ถ้าท่านใดทำไทมุกเฟส2เฟส3นะครับวันนี้ท่านมาอยู่เดี๋ยวจะเจออาจารย์ปวินยาอาจารย์มณีรัตน์กับผม2วันซ้อนเลยที่ห้อง215สำหรับท่านที่ทำไทมุกเฟส2และเฟส3นะครับ Next we have room number 217 in English language this one will be close groupin by invitation only it will be collaboration discussion between Taiwan MOOC edX and Thai MOOC so this is it for this afternoon I wish you stay and choose the room that you want and before we go to lunch one person lost your earbud so it is with me just come forward to me and I will return it to you okay
Now I would like to invite you all to enjoy the secret and delicious lunch at the room next door. Thank you.
Thank you. Enjoy your lunch. Bon appétit.